Kanish Adam, first. 38 September 2005. All of you, do along with me. How much money I give as check? 2000. They allot me at what NAV? 19.45. 102.83 units allotted on 31st December 2005, another 2000 given at what NAV allotted? 21.5. 2000 by 21.5, that gives me 93.02. 31st March, another 2000 given at what rate allotted? 27.15. 2000 by 27.15, 73.66. 38th June, another 2000 given, the NAV rate allotted is 23.69. 2000 divided by 23.69. How many units has been allotted? 84.42. Units allotted is 84.42. Can I proceed up? No. The total is 353.93. Everybody understanding it or not? No. These are all the number of units. Tell me the value. Each unit is what? How much rupees? 23.69 into 353.93. Tell me the amount. 8,384.6. But you invested only how much rupees? 8,000. The balance is the yield. Okay. Percentage yield is equal to, tell me the calculation, right? What is the calculation? 384.6 divided by 8000 into 100 into 12 by 9. 384.6 by 8000 into 100 into 12 by 9. Tell me the number. 6.41%. Which is giving me more return? A or B? Mutual fund A has given me more return. Okay, write down. Mutual fund A has given more return. Okay. Listen here. My question is, since I am buying at only 10 rupees, here I have to buy the units how much rupees? 19.45. Then I got allotted 200 units. I got allotted only what? 102 units. Due to this only, A is having an advantage. True or false? Everybody fall in order. The date when I enter, if the NAV is very low, then that is going to be the advantage. I enter there at 10 rupees and I enter at what? 19.5. Since I enter at 10 rupees, it is advantageous. True or false? False. Because the 10 and 19.5 is a starting point. From there, how much percentage NAV grows is important. From where you start is not important, because I enter 19.5, it will go up to 23 or 24. Respond. Yes or no? I enter 10, will not go up to 23, will go only up to 12 or 13. What I am saying? So, in that case, what is the NAV percentage grown from the base NAV is important, but not what NAV I am entering into. Everybody are really following saying that is not at all relevant is what I am going to say. Very simple, yeah. Buying a MTH shares at 80 rupees, buying what? TCA shares at what? 2000. Don't say TCA is too costly because it starts going from 2000. Yes, sir. It will not become that 80 can never become 2500, yeah, correct? Are you following what I am saying? So, wherever you start, from there I should see what? What the return? Any approach? One thing is you have entered a very high price, that is a different issue. But what? That can also be for 80 rupees. Yes, sir. Suppose 90 rupees I buy an MTH cash share, I buy two TCS, how much rupees? 2000 rupees. Tell me, am I buying at a low price of MTH cash share? No. This 90 rupees share, it still may be what? Highly priced, may become 88. The 2000 may be what? Underpriced, has got a chance to reach what? 2800 also. So at what stage I'm entering, that entry level NAV doesn't matter for my return is also the question that has been asked. Everybody respond, yes or no? Yes, sir. Write down notes. Write down notes. Point number one. Now these points I will miss out. Okay, that is why I am just dictating notes. Point number one. In SIP na systematic investment plan. In SIP, an investor invest regular amounts in mutual fund. And the fund allots units. And the fund allots units at the NAV prevailing on the date of investment. Whenever I give a check, I am investing na, on the date, it will be giving me the units and the NAV prevailing on the date of investment. Point number one, everybody yes or no? No. Same point you continue. It is similar to what? RD. Everybody following or not? Next, point number two. The advantage of SIP is that the unit holder will not be affected. The unit holder will not be affected greatly by the fluctuations in NAV. Because branch it into two. First branch, NAV increases. Two things can happen, na? NAV increases. Second branch, what? NAV decreases. NAV increases, put it down, you can write. Happy because, in examination and all, don't write the word happy and all, only for that I am saying, okay, happy because, okay, jolly because, happy because his existing units value increased. His existing units value increased. Second branch, NAV what? Decreases. Happy and happy? Happy because he gets more units allotted. He gets more units allotted for his investment. Now, see, this is a beautiful plan because what happens is always people have to buy when the market is low. Yes, we all do the panic selling then only. Share price crash now, what you'll do? Be the first person to run and sell it. Yes, that is when the Sensex touched $8,000 in 2007, when somebody say go and buy shares, nobody will buy. Now the Sensex has come back to what? 2000 cross, it is now becoming what? 23, etc. Right? In that case, those who bought the index funds, or those who bought what? Mutual funds, or those invest in what? Shares, at that time will be reaping great benefit today. And human psychology, when something is falling or crashing, we'll be afraid of what? Buy it. But if you put us in the sentiments and put in SIP, what happens is you'll be automatically bound to buy that units. I'm going to come out of it. Yeah. So when the market is crashing also, you'll be investing what? The same 2000 rupees and getting what? More units will help you in the later stage. Yes or no? Normally, good performing fund or good performing share, if you consistently invest over a long period in the entire market, one will not be losing. Because if you see the track, every index they give a track, they give one a track, where the Sensex from Independence Day onwards, that is Independence Day, from the date of Independence onwards what till now, okay, like that, every decade they just want to track the movements. Always share market has outperformed what all the other markets, and the return will not be 30%, 40%, that is all too much to expect. In the gain or loss, it has been what evened out. One can on an average expect 13 to 14% return from what share market in a given period. It may be very abnormally high during 2001 to what 2005, maybe low in the next period, suffering what losses, may once again become what high. But if you consistently keep on investing without pulling out, then one will be able to earn a long term return. That can be done through what? Mutual funds in an SIP plan. Everybody are able to follow what I am saying? It's the advantage of a systematic investment plan. Can I proceed or not? Now, with this week, and one more point, point number three. At what NAV we enter is not relevant. At what NAV we enter is not relevant. How much it grows only is relevant. At what NAV we enter is irrelevant. At what NAV we enter is irrelevant. How much it grows is only relevant. How much it grows is only relevant. How much it grows is only relevant. Then answer has been made. Can I proceed or not? Now, with this we have completed a solution to question number 11. Are you following up? Now, they are now doing what problems? Yield calculation problems. Any correct? No. Take question number 16. Market as very important. Already 3 times in examination this question has been asked. They again ask this question in the examination. Very regular, a very standard problem, can be asked for 8 to 10 marks in the examination. Okay, take question number 16. Similar problems are there in the practice manual also, study material and RTPS. Okay, now the chapter number problems are all standardized. If you don't understand by heart, you can do it. Can I go say it? No, examples. Okay, now, but nothing to understand. All are simple calculation compared to portfolio. Nothing. Can I go say it? No. Take question number 16, please. Shh. Yes, yeah. Okay, please. Sun Moon Mutual Fund. Why the name given Sun Moon? Yeah, it can either be bright or go down. Yes or no? So Sun Moon can be hot as well as what? Cold. Hot and cold. Okay. Sun Moon Mutual Fund, approved mutual fund, sponsored open-ended equity oriented scheme, Chanakya Opportunity Fund. Why Chanakya? Intelligently investing. Okay, now. Institute problem, yeah, they gave the names. Okay, there are 3 plans: dividend reinvestment plan, bonus plan, and growth plan. Please. At the time of initial offer on 1/4/1995, Mr. Anand, Mr. Bachchan, and Ms. Charu. Okay, now. Mr. Bachchan, can I go say it? Now. 3 investors invested rupees 1 lakh each and chosen plan B, C and A respectively. Please. The history of the fund is as follows. So they given 28/7/99, 31/8, a small change make, 31/8/2000, 31/10/2003, like that different dates are given. How much dividend percentage declared? what is the bonus ratio declared? 3 sets of NAVs are given. On 31st July, all 3 investors redeemed all the balance units. Calculate annual rate of return to the investor. Consider the following. Long-term capital gain is exempt from income tax. Short-term capital gain is taxed at 10%. Security transaction tax at 0.2% only on the sale or redemption of units. Ignore education cess. In the question, okay, please go through the question before I start with the solution. Shall I proceed? Huh? Okay. See. Mutual fund always comes out with schemes. How company invests in different projects? Like that, mutual fund comes out with the schemes. Okay. Now, they may say, now we're coming with a new equity plan. That means they're going to invest the money in what? Equity shares. They can say, come with a new debt plan. They invest in what? The bonds. There's a hybrid model. They invest in what? Equity and debt. They come out with an infrastructure fund. That means they invest only in what? Infrastructure companies. They say power fund. They invest only in what? Power. Gold fund. They invest only in what? Gold. Like that, the fund announces what schemes? Announces what schemes? They announce a scheme and start collecting IPO. Same mutual fund. The mutual fund is an entity. Like how a company can have different industry undertakings, na? Like that, there's going to be a same fund. It'll be coming into what? Different schemes. You can be a unit holder in one of the scheme. Everybody, yes or no? Now, like that, funds always come up with schemes. For the scheme, they collect what? The money and then start investing as per the guidelines given in the scheme. You respond, are you following what I'm saying? Now, see. When you invest in a scheme, when you go for an IPO and invest in a mutual fund in a given scheme, they ask you how you want to receive the incomes. How you want to receive what? Incomes. Okay. Do you want to go for a dividend reinvestment scheme? Do you want to go for what? A bonus? Do you want to go for what? A growth? A simple dividend plan. Everybody follow what I'm saying now? You have to put a tick. Based on the how I am going to distribute, the mutual fund schemes can be classified into four types. What are four types of schemes here? Dividend reinvestment plan. Number two is what? Bonus plan. Number three is what? Growth plan. Number four is what? The simple dividend plan. Dividend in cash plan. Respond is or no? No. So in that, in dividend plan, they give a dividend in cash. What is that? In dividend reinvestment, they give you dividend in cash, but convert into what? Units. On that date, NAV, and then give you. Respond is or no? Bonus, no, they don't give you dividend. They allot what? Bonus units. Sometime with their field. Is or no? Growth, no, nothing they will give you. They always keep the money with them, and they ensure the growth in NAV. Respond is or no? Now, in that case, what happens is, they'll maintain separate NAV for the investors on each category. You are in dividend reinvestment plan, your NAV is what? Different. Growth plan, NAV is what? Different and so on. Say they report what? Two or three NAVs for the same fund based on what? The plan you adopted. Any approach? Yes, sir. You know, dividend person has received dividend, you cannot have high NAV. Growth has 4 and 1. Dividend is anything should be 1. Higher. I cannot equate both with the same NAV. S-O-N-O. In that case, they report 1. Separate NAV for the persons in each plan. S-O-N-O. Now, in this case, 3 persons, Anand, Bachchan, Charu, ABC, all the 3 as what? Invested in the same Chanakya fund. But one has opted for the dividend reinvestment, and second for what? Bonus, and third for what? Growth. The first column NAV, you have to understand in the same existing generates. The first column NAV represents what? NAV for a dividend reinvestment plan person. The second column NAV is for what? A bonus person. The third column NAV is for what? A growth person. So all the three invested the same 1 lakh when the fund opened. When the fund opened 1995. The fund opened at face value of 10 rupees or not. At that time everybody invested what? 1 lakh. Now after 10 years, what is going to be the return they are earning if they went for the 3 plans? In a question given. For everybody the dates are different. For the dividend plan, 28-7-99 120% dividend given. 31st August another 70% dividend given. 31st October another 40% dividend given. Any apprehension? Now, like that, these are all the dividend declaration dates. Like that, bonus ratio is given on different dates. Growth, nothing to worry. Only thing is what? I invested 95. I look back only after what? 10 years. The units remain same, but the NAV is what? Grown multifold. Everybody, yes or no? Now, from all the three, the answer to calculate what? Yield. I calculate yield as done by the RTP. And also give what a better way to calculate the CAGR, compound on annual growth rate return also. Can I proceed or not? Now, in this one or two issues regarding taxes involved. So, I think bonus units tax is zero. That is not tax is zero. The cost accretion is what? Zero. But in the RTP, how they did, I'll do it. I'll give you the note also for the adjustments to be made. Can I proceed or not? No. You can also give the note in the exam. I don't know how they'll be putting in the next examination. Can I proceed? Now, let's start with the solution. A long solution, but a very important problem. Can I start or not? No. First, write out part 1, dividend reinvestment plan. I want everybody to take the calculator, do and then tell me without checking a number, don't write it. Okay. Dividend reinvestment plan, highly repeated type of problem in the exam, FAQ, frequently asked questions. Is that frequently RAQ, means what? Regularly asked question. Can I go say? So it is dividend reinvestment plan. Dividend reinvestment plan. Can I start? No. Open the following columns. We'll do every row together. Okay, let us do it together. You should intimate me the calculation, understood or not, then I can just proceed further. Can you start or not? Now, date, investment, NAV, units, cumulative units. First, when I enter the mutual fund first, what is the first entry date? Tell me. 1st April 1995. 19 years back. 1st April 1995. What is the investment? 1 lakh. Investment is 1 lakh. At the generally fund issues IPO at face value. Okay, what is the IPO? 10 rupees. IPO NAV is 10 rupees. First, they were allotted how many units? 1 lakh units. Okay, 10,000 units. What is going to be? 10,000. Cumulative units, 10,000. Cumulative units, 10,000. Can I proceed on? Next. Next happening date is what? 28-7-99. 28-7-99. Now, stop writing and tell me, dividend percentage will be applied on market value or face value? Face value. How the interest percentage coupon apply on face value, like that dividend percentage also applied on what? Face value only. Yes or no? No. Number of units held into face value into percentage give the amount of dividend. Yes or no? Tell me. On 28th July 1999, how many units are holding? 10,000 units. every unit, how much face value? 10 rupees. What the face value of the amount held? 1 lakh. On how much I declare dividend? 20%. So the dividend is 20,000. What the dividend here? 20,000. That becomes an investment for me because I want to alert invest for that. Yes or no? The dividend check will not be given to you. It is going to be what? Reinvested. The investment amount is 20,000. Accept or not? No. This 20,000 rupees will be made as units at what NAV? NAV on the date. Tell me what NAV? 30.7. At NAV of 30.7. You can check my numbers also for safety. NAV is 30.7. 20,000 divided by 30.7. How many units will be allotted? Tell me. 651.46 units allotted. Tell me from that day onwards, I am a owner of how many units? 10,651 units. I just rounded off there. 10,651 units. Okay, I just rounded off. Yeah, has been done inside. If you write 10,651.46, nothing at all, much more accurate. Can I present or not? No. Next is. Next happening date. Tell me the happening date. Next is what? 31st August 2000. I made a change in the workbook. The number has made as what? August. Workbook la maathiniya ba? I asked you to change as 31st August. Right or not? No. You are all sleeping now, awake. I made the change or not? No. Next. Tell me. How many units is entitled dividend? 10,651. Each unit has how much face value? 10 rupees. So 1,06,510 rupees is the capital on it. How much dividend? 70%. Somebody take the calculator or everybody take the calculator. Tell me what the number is. 74,557. 74,557. That is 1,06,510 into 70% gives you 74,557. This money I am investing or not? I am investing at what NAV? 58.42. 58.42. How many units? 1,276.22. Tell me what is the now units totally with me? 11,927. I round off to the whole numbers, but should be in what? Decimals. That's how has been done. Copied. Okay, you can write in decimals in the exam. 11,927 units. Next. Next date is what? 31st October 2003. Answer me, I am entitled dividend on how many units? 11,927. The dividend will be applied on how much value? 1,19,270. On it, how much percentage will be applied? 40%. I want you to take the calculator. 119,270 into 40%. What the dividend amount here? 47,708. The dividend amount is 47,708. On the date, what is the NAV? 42.18. How many units will be allotted? 1,131.01. The cumulative units going to be how much here? 13,058 units. 13,058 units. Respond. Yes or no? No. Next. Next happening date is what? 15th March 2004. I am entitled to dividend on how many units? 13,058 units. Dividend will be applied on what amount? 1,30,580. At what percent? 25%. Calculator. You do it. What's the number here? It is how much? 32,645. The dividend amount is 32,645. Understanding or not? 32,645. Should be divided by how much NAV? Please tell me the NAV. 46.45. Divided by NAV 46.45. How many units allotted? 702.79 units. What total units? 137. That is 761. 13,761 units. Next happening date is what? 24th March 2005. I made us 24th March. Make it as what? 24th. March only. Okay. Slide a small mistake. 24th March 2005. Okay. Slide a small mistake is the. Made us 24th March 2005. Tell me how many units entitled dividend? 13,761. What is the value on which percentage should be applied? 1,37,016. In how much percent? 40%. Tell me the investment amount. 55,044. On that day, tell me the NAV. What is the NAV? 48.1. NAV is 48.1. How many units have been allotted? 1144.36. What are the units I'm holding at the end of that particular day? 14,905. I'm having 14,905 units. 14,905 units. Everybody understanding it or not? No. Marshaba? Okay, now you are having how many units? 14,905 on which day? 24th March 2005. Get up. Yes, and this person sold all his units on which date? 31st July 2005. Any correct? Now on 31st July 2007 he sold how much NAV? 53.75. Enna pa idam not na. He invested 1 lakh rupees. Now he'll be getting some money on 31st July or not? The difference is returned even by him through capital appreciation. In the right or not? Now, in this, let us understand some calculation before I proceed. Can I proceed? Now, first, no need to copy. Participate. I'll give you time to copy this particular slide. Small slide only. Can I proceed? Now, solluppa. Now, how many units I am selling on 31st July? 14,905. Because after March, nothing has been purchased or sold. How many is I'm selling here? 14,905. At what NAV? 53.75. Will I get the check from the exchange? At so much money up? No. Because there's a security transaction tax. How much percent? 0.2%. What I get is in hand is only what? 99.8%. Any correct? I sell for 100, I get only what? 99.8, because point to goes as what? STT. In the case, what is the money that I get from the sales policy? 7,99,541. In the case, this full money, my money? No. On this, I have to pay what? Short term capital gain tax, if there is any. Is there a short term capital gain there or not? Yes. For units and all, 1 year. Is there any unit which I have purchased within a year period of sale? What units here? 24th March 2005, I purchased 1144 units. Correct? That unit, did I keep it for 1 year, less than 1 year, less than 1 year? I sold on what? July, the same year itself. So I have to pay what? A short term capital gain tax on that. Please tell me, yes or no? I bought those units at how much price? 48.10. Now I am selling for how much rupees? How much base here? 53.75. Into what? 99.8. STD is allowed as deduction. Get up. Enna pa ready not now. In that case, 53.75 into 99.8% is what? Sales value. And what is the purchase cost here? 48.10. The difference is what? Capital gain. And how many units are? 1144 units. On this, I have to pay how much tax given the question here? 10%. I get the tax to be paid. Enna pa ready ta? Yes or no? No. In that case, see, less capital gains, 1,144 units are subjected to what? Short-term capital gain tax. It was purchased at how much? 48.1. Now sold at what? 53.75. After STT is going to be what? 53.75 into 99.8%. Yeah, this is the gain I make total. On which how much tax? 10%. This 664 rupees. Respond is or no? That means after tax sales proceeds in my hand is how much rupees here? 7,98,907. Point number two. Respond is or no? Now, I have got 7,98,907 on which date? 31st July 2005. I invest on what date? 1st April 1995. How much rupees here? 1 lakh. The difference is a return given by me or not? The return you earn for 1 year, more than one year, I earn for 122 months. Yes, sir. Because 1st April 1995 to what? 31st March 2005, 120 months. Yes, sir. Then what? April, May, June, July, 4 months. You know how many months? 4 months. This is a 124 months return. How many months return? 124 months return. What is 12 months return? How to what? Find out to analyze it. Enna apurinjida? Na. If you look at the calculation, 7,19,907 is the amount in hand. What investing is what? 1 lakh. 6,19,907 is what? Here. By investing how much to pay is? 1 lakh. For how much period here? 124 months. What is for 12 months? Into 100 into 12 by 124 gives how much? 67.64%. Gives how much? 67.64%. Enna pa right anna? So this is the answer for this particular sum. 67.64% is the return. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Can I proceed further? Now. Finish copying? Okay, copy this quickly. Copy this. Tax rates as given in the question paper, you apply it. Sometimes what happens is they may repeat the same sum without applying the mind. Okay, in such case you can do as it is the tax rate given, whereas answer will not match with the key. Mostly institute gives you the current tax rate and current provisions only, but if they give you the old problem, do as it has been given. You need not change. You want to just give a note of any changes happen in the tax law. Okay. Finish copying on. Those who have not copied, raise your hand. Shall I proceed?
Yes, sir.
You have finished, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now. This is a normal way of calculating. But a much more accurate way is called as CAGR. It's called as what? CAGR. In news channels also, they always put the CAGR means what? Compounded annual growth rate. It's considering reinvestment also. Time value of money is what? Considered. Let us see how the CAGR should be calculated. Right now, next. Expressing yield as CAGR, compounded annual growth rate. Expressing yield as compounded annual growth rate. Expressing yield as compounded annual growth rate. Compounded annual growth rate. This is already known to us. Can I proceed or not? Now, we all know the formula. Future value is equal to, so what the value? Present value into 1 plus r power n. Present value into 1 plus r power n. What is the future value? 7,98,907 is equal to, I start with how much rupees investment? 1 lakh. That's grown to how much percent? R percent. For how many months? 124 months. 7,98,907 is equal to 1 lakh into 1 plus r power 124. Inna par right or not? Now. Next right. 1 plus r power 124 is equal to 7.98907. 1 plus r power 124 is equal to 7.98907. Purinjuda? No. I want what? 1 plus r is equal to 124th root of what? 7.98907. Difficult, easy, easy. You know how to calculate that or not? So, Yamargaba, this chapter, bond valuation. It or not? Now, take the calculator, take the calculator. Type what? 7.98907. Type 7.98907. Press square root how many times? 15 times. All of you do at least once before the batch completes. Plus square root 15 times. Minus 1. Minus 1. Divided by what? 124. Divided by 124. Plus 1. Then into is equal to plus how many times? 15 times. Into is equal to 15 times. Tell me what is the contingent? 1 plus r is equal to how much? 1.0169. Please. 1.0169. Is that correct? Huh? R is equal to what? R is equal to point? Point? 0169. How much percentage? Yeah? Either one mistake is there, yeah. Ah, okay. 1.69. Right there. Yeah. Right. 1.69 per month. Is going to be what? Per month. In how many months here? 12 months. Okay. What is per annum? 20.28. That's normal. 20.28% per annum. Don't think that fund has earned you around 67% humbug because they don't give you any money to reinvest. Had they reinvested, they earned an IR how much percent? 20.28. This is a real performance of the fund is what? CAGR. Response, no. Don't always look at the simple interest when they don't give you money. You have to always look at what? Compounded interest. Because you have reinvested dividend, you should earn a say compounded return or not. How much should be? 20.28% is a compounded annual growth rate. You call us what? CAGR. Compounded annual growth rate. Please. In the money value. 20.28. I think everybody has finished writing along with me or not? Those are not copied, raise your hand. Finish Amma, those are back. Can I proceed? No. Let's go to the next person. Next is what fund? Bonus fund. Okay. Now one was the calculator will be much more smaller and simpler. Can I proceed? Now, write down. Part 2, bonus plan. Let's do it together. Part 2, bonus plan. Part 2, bonus plan. Date, bonus, units. Date, bonus, units. Shall we start up? Now, tell me. When we enter the scheme first? First April 95. No bonus then. They allotted me how many units? 10,000 units. Inga bonus plan ki NAV endral not required. They straight away give me the units. Kalapa? So allotted me 10,000 units. When the bonus was declared? 31st August 2000. Number, yeah, okay. You just forgot about the number. 31st August 2000. Some number, okay. Now, what ratio? 5 is to 4. How to read that 5 is to 4? For 4 units held, they give me what? 5 units bonus. A bonus ratio 1 is to 2 means what? For 2 units, they give me what? 1 unit. Yes or no? Now, in that case, divided by what? 4 into 5. How many bonus units? 12,500. Now, the units in hand is how many units? 22,500. Is that correct? Now, next date is what? 31st March 2004. What the bonus ratio? 1 is to 3. For every 3 units, 1 unit given. For 22,500 units, how many units given? 7,500. The units on hand is how much? 30,000. Units on hand is 30,000. And on next date is what? 24th March. How many units allocated? For 4 units, 1 unit. So for 30,000 units, 7,500. The units on hand is 37,500. 37,500. Shulupa, yes or no? My question is, these 37,500 units I am selling on which day? 31st July. He also comes out on the same day. At what amount? 22.98. Will I get the entire 22.98? No. Into what? 99.8. Can we start doing it together, the slide, or not? No. Right on. Sales proceeds is equal to 37,500 into 22.98 into 99.8%. Now STT Ghana balance will get 99.8%. What's the number? 860,026. 860,026 rupees. 860,026. Everything minor, any tax will be paid? Yes, there's a short term capital gain, because one of the units, that is what? 7,500, allotted on what? 24.3. He is held for less than 1 year or not? No. Generally, for this, what are the cost of acquisition? Zero. On the entire amount, I have to calculate the tax, right or not? No. But institute has reduced from this NAV, the NAV on the data bonus. You do it as it is and leave it as a note also later. Can I proceed or not? No. I asked whether any mutual fund specific provision is there with the Soumya answer. He said no, it is going to be what? Zero only cost of acquisition. But how they did this? Very simple. On the date, someone thought when he was alert or not? On the date, there's going to be some NAV or not? Yes, that NAV prevailing on the date of what? The bonus units issue is taken as what? The cost reduced from what? The sale price NAV and balance treated as a gain. We can do as it is. Can I proceed? No. Now, I just done as per the Institute study material. Can I proceed? Now, less capital gain, 7,500 units into, I sold at 22.98, got only 99.8%, into 22.98 into 99.8% minus, on the date of allotment 24th March, what the NAV? 19.95. Into 10% gain 2238. Into 10% gain 2238. Finish writing up now. Net sales proceeds after tax. Sales proceeds after tax 857,788. Sales proceeds after tax 857,788. Same calculation. Annualized return is equal to 857,788 minus 1 lakh. 857,788 minus 1 lakh divided by 1 lakh into 100 divided by 1 lakh into 100 into 12 by 124. 73.33%. Into 12 by 124, 73.33%. Can you leave the CAGR for you to do on your own as a homework or not? No. I think I know how to do it. Same way as the last sum, the number only changes. Okay, now. Let us also calculate CAGR. Bracket right, homework. If you go home and see, you know that work. Okay, so also calculate CAGR. Respond, yes or no? No. Last plan done, jolly. What is last plan here? Growth plan. Nothing to do. Straight away only what? Maturity. Okay, now. Finish copying or not? Now. Last plan is what? Growth plan. Pathway is growth plan. Can I proceed? Now. Sales proceeds. 1 lakh into 82.07 into 99.8%. 10,000 into 82.07 into 99.8%. What the number? 8,19,058. No short term capital gain, no units are allotted later. Is or no? No. Annualized return. 819,058 minus 1 lakh. 819,058 minus 1 lakh divided by 1 lakh into 100 divided by 1 lakh into 100 into 12 by 124. divided by 1 lakh into 100 into 12 by 124. Tell me, what is the number? 69.59%. Number is 69.59%. Number is 69.59%. Everybody, following not? Also calculate, right? Also calculate what? CAGR. Okay, homework. Also calculate CAGR, homework. Also calculate CAGR. This sum, have you all understood or not? No. With this, we have completed this particular problem. Now, can give somebody give me the learning objectives, sir? There is no notes required for this. Calculation self-evident, correct? No. Please. Shh. Calculation of NAV over, correct? Now, yield calculation has been done in number of problems. Then different types of scheme based on income distribution, dividend plan over, dividend reinvestment plan over, growth plan over, bonus plan over. Respond yes or no. Now, systematic investment plan has been completed or not? Yes. Now what I do is, I'll do the seventh part, a very small part, 2 minutes calculation, your return versus what? Mutual fund return. I'll do that. Regularly asking the examination for the 3 marks or 4 marks. We'll do that and then go for the remaining, please. Now, give the heading, your return versus mutual fund return, please. Your return versus mutual fund return. There's a standard formula. Let us write it and then substitute it, then understand it later. 1 minute sum, these sums. Okay. Now, your return versus mutual fund return. Underline that. Write in that. MFR is equal to mutual fund return is equal to, write the formula along with me. Mutual fund return is equal to your return divided by 100 minus issue expenses. Your return divided by 100 minus issue expenses plus RC means recurring charges. 100 minus issue expenses plus recurring charges. Plus recurring charges. When I elaborated, MFR means what? Mutual fund return. MFR means mutual fund return. YR means what? Your return. Can I proceed on? Now, IE means what? Issue expenses. And RC means what? Recurring charges. RC means recurring charges. Everybody, can I proceed or not? No. See, the concept is simple. I can invest directly in stock market. Everybody, listen. I can invest directly in what? Stock market. Or I can access the stock market through mutual fund. Yes, sir. Now, if I invest directly in stock market and earn 15% return, I'm earning 15% return. Yes, sir. But if the mutual fund earns the same 15% return, enough or not? Question. It is not enough. The reason is, if the fund earns 15% return, what reaches me ultimately is what? Less than 15% return, because when I invest in the fund, a part of it goes for what? Units, issue expenses, the balance only can be invested. Yes, sir. Apart from that, they have to earn some amount, everyone meet their what? Recurring charges like asset management fees or operating expenses, etc., etc. It is not in that case. If I can earn on my own 15%, the fund should earn something around 17% or what? 18%. So that after meeting the units issue expenses, after meeting what? Recurring charges, they're going to give me what? The required 15%. In the Papunjara, either because mutual fund return versus your return. More you can understand with the help of the numbers. Everybody following? Now, tell me what the formula? Mutual fund return should be equal to what? Your return divided by 100 minus issue expenses plus what? Recurring charges is the answer. Any approach that? No. Take question number one. Take question number one. Now the time is 8:30. Within 8:45, one should complete 1, 2, and 3. Within 8:40, one should complete what? 1, 2, and 3. Can I proceed or not? No. Take question number one. Irpash. you can earn a return of 15%, don't talk, by investing in equity shares on your own. So what is your return? 15%. You are considering a recently announced equity mutual fund scheme where the initial issue expense is 15% and the recurring annual expenses are 2%. How much should the mutual fund scheme earn to provide a return of 15% to you? Idam question. Everybody saw no. So they ask you to find out how much a mutual fund should earn. Should they earn only 15%? No. Because if they earn only 15, after making recurring and all, I won't be getting what? The desired money. They should be earning more than what? 15%. Idam question. Inna parayda? No. Can I start doing the solution? No. Write down. Question number one. Please. Question number one. We'll do it together. Question number one. No need to write the formula. It is already there. No? Mutual fund return is equal to, substitute simply, mutual fund return is equal to, what is your return? 15. Divided by, write as 15. Divided by, what minus what? 100 minus, what is your expenses? 15. 15 by 100 minus 15 plus, what are the recurring charges? Don't write 2, write as what? 0.02. Since I am not multiplying by 100, write as what? Decimals, 0.02. Any apprentice? No. Tell me, what is 15 by 85? Number solupa? 0.17. 15 by 85, what is the number? 0.1765. Plus what? 0.02. 0.02. What is the total? 0.1965. Or how much percent? 19.65%. How much percent return? 19.65%. Very simple, yeah? All the fund holders, unit pro holders, gives the fund 100 rupees. Can fund invest 100 rupees? No. For its unit issue expenses, etc., it has spent how much? 15. The amount invest is only what? 85. If I invest, I have to earn 15 and 100, but they have to earn what? 15 and 85. Yes or no? Apart from that, they have to also earn what? 2%. Every year has what? Recurring expenses. So the total, they should be earning how much percent? 19.65% is the answer. Any approach to that? Is a mutual fund return. Can I say, write down notes. Point number one. An investor can invest directly in equity. An investor can invest directly in equity. An investor can invest directly in equity. An investor can invest directly in equity or through what? Mutual funds. An investor can invest directly in equity or through mutual funds. Point number two. If he earns 15% through direct investment, then to give him the same 15%, the fund should earn. The fund should earn how much percent? 19.65. They should earn so much so that after meeting all their expenses, when they give you, how much can be in the hand? 15%. The fund should earn how much percent? 19.65%. So that after meeting issue expense and recurring charges, how much percent? 15%. Can I proceed up? No. Let us quickly do the remaining two sums. Okay, in no time. Each sum should not take more than 30 seconds to do. Can I proceed? 1 minute than time allotted. Can I proceed? No. And even check the stopwatch. Can I proceed? No. don't include a question reading time. Kadambasi. You can earn 13% return by investing in share on your own. You are considering a recently announced equity mutual fund scheme where initial issue expense is 5% and recurring annual expenses are 1.8%. How much should the mutual fund scheme earn to provide a 13% return? Can I push it or not? Now, write down question number 2, please. This is a past examination problem, question number 2. What the formula? Mutual fund return is equal to your return divided by 100 minus issue expense plus recurring charges. Your return by 100 minus issue expense plus recurring charges. What is your return? 13 divided by 100 minus 5. 13 divided by 100 minus 5 plus what is recurring charges? Yellow percent? 2.8. 1.8. That is 0.018. 1.8. Tell me correct or full or what is the total? 15.48%. Answer over. Yes or no? Now, right. Question number 3. Take question number 3. What is over? Take question number 3, please. You can earn a return of 14% by investing in equity shares on your own. You are considering a recently announced equity mutual fund scheme where the initial issue expenses is 6%. You believe that the mutual fund scheme will earn 16.5%. What is the recurring expenses in percentage term? Will you be indifferent between investing your own and investing through the mutual fund? Can I say now? They give you the mutual fund return, your return, issue expense. Ask you to find out what? Recurring charges. Innappa, write or not? Now. Can I do it together? Now, write down first. Mutual fund return is equal to your return divided by 100 minus issue expense plus recurring charges. Your return by 100 minus issue expense plus recurring charges. Have they given mutual fund return or not? Yes. How much percent? 16.5. Write as what? 0.165 is equal to. What is your return? 14 divided by 100 minus 6 plus what? Recurring charges. Recurring charges equal to 0.165 minus. What is 14 by 94? What number? 0.1489. 0.165 minus 0.1489. How much it is? 0.0161. Or how much percent? 1.61%. Answer is 1.61%. The recurring charge is going to be 1.61%. Everybody, yes or no? Now. So 2 minutes exceeded. Can I push it or not? Now. With this, I complete question number 1, 2, as well as what? 3. Please. Take question number 17. Mark it as important. RTP sum. Take question number 17. Okay. So this is called as portfolio strategies. How one can invest money in portfolios. Okay, portfolio strategies. Tell me, should you put all the money in equities, all the money in fixed deposits, mix. One should say invest in what? Mix. So the growth also can be seen. Stability in income also can be what? Ensure. They should be having some mix. Okay. Based on this, we compare two strategies. Passive buy and hold strategy on constant proportion plan. It is given in the study material in the portfolio management. I just put it in what? Mutual funds. Okay. This is an RTP sum and the next sum is a study material problem. Study material problem, I give it as a homework. It is there in study material as a solved answer. I need not do it. I'll do the RTP sum. That is question number 17. It is a much more longer sum. Can I put it or not? Now, one small mistake is there in the solution that we'll assume and do it. Can I proceed up? No. Mistake can be assumed. Can I proceed? First. Miss Sunidhi That means what? She is managing fund well. Okay. He is working with an MNC at Mumbai. She is well versed with the portfolio management techniques and wants to test one of the techniques on an equity fund she has constructed and compare with the gain and losses from the technique with those from a passive buy and hold strategy. The fund consists of equities only and the ending NAVs of the fund as he or she constructed for the last 10 months are given below. Month December to September NAVs are given. Assume Sunidhi invested a notional amount of 2 lakhs equally in the equity fund and conservative portfolio of bonds in the beginning of December 2008, and the total portfolio was being rebalanced each time the NAV of the fund increased or decreased by 15%. You are required to determine the value of the portfolio for each level of NAV following the constant ratio plan. A very important problem can be asked anytime in the examination. Okay, it is an RTP question. Same constant ratio plan. Next problem, a small problem with only 3 numbers is given in the study material. Okay, now there is no need to give you time to read the question. I'll explain and then start doing the solution. They can write the numbers together. A long answer. We're going to write it. Can I start or not? Please. Okay, I'll tell you the basic underlying logic and then start doing the solution. Please. This one can even follow in real life. It is a very sane way of making investment. Always an investor should not be sentimental, should not panic. Generally for any investment, mainly equities in the markets, one should not be sentimental, one should not act mainly on instincts. There are people who act on instincts, it may work, but always investment should be somewhat systematic, where your scheme should be uninfluenced by your sentiments. Are you following what I'm saying? Now, even if you don't like to do something, you should be doing it for the sake of the rule. Are you following what I'm saying? If you do like that, we'll have a consistency in what? Investment policy, and one can on a long run make a decent return. Everybody follow what I'm saying? Now, because sometimes what happens is, when the market is very bullish, market is what? Very bullish, we want to buy more and more. Yes, temptation, yeah, because yesterday there was a TCS as a 2000, now become what? 2200. Then you say 200 jump, let me buy what? No, let me buy what? More. What happens is, suddenly it will be crashing. I follow what I'm saying? Now, one should avoid the temptation of buying when the prices are rising. Yes, okay, one should also have what? Avoid a fear of what? Buying when the prices are low. But nobody can understand whether price is going to rise or what? Fall. One should have what? A system through which dispassionately one should go about what? Investment. For that only SIP, one of the strategies. Where you don't worry about price increase and decrease, always put what? 2000 and get the units. I don't look at NAV gain or loss. Now, another plan is what? This constant ratio plan. The ratio may differ, but let's understand the plan now. Can I put it or not? Now, see, I have suppose 1 lakh rupees. How much rupees is here? 1 lakh. What I can do is, I can put 50-50 in 2 items. One is a bond, another is what? Equity. Bond is a debt instrument, gives you a safe return. Correct? Equity gives me what? A variable return. I mean, understand? Why not? Can't I invest in what? Yeah, post office, etc. I don't like to invest in FD at all, because if you want to sell, I cannot sell it. Yes, that debt should be what? Saleable. As well as what? Should be giving a stable return. Like that, identify bond and invest. Point number one. Yes or no? Now, see what happens. I'll just give an example. Today, I invested in bond and then what? Equity. One example, not this sum. How much rupees? 50,000. How much rupees here? 50,000. Next. That means my portfolio value is how much rupees? 1 lakh. This thing is going to remain same. Whatever bond will always remain what? Same. If it all moves a small number up and down, that's all. Due to yield change, you forget about that. I'm going to hold it for what? Long. I always value at face value. So this value is same. This 50,000 one day can become what? 70. Another can become what? 40. Anything can happen. I don't know. Now, suppose what happens is the share price has dropped. The share price has what? Dropped. In that case, this 50,000 on a day, on the some day, okay, has become 40,000, and this became what? 50,000. What the value? 90,000. Now my portfolio is 90,000 or not? My question is this 90,000 ratio one issue or not? No. The proportion has changed, isn't it? Why? Because the market value has what? Decreased. I should try to maintain a constant proportion. Right? Maintain what? Constant proportion. That means this 90 should not be in 50, 40. It should be what? 45,000 and then what? 45,000. What I will do is, I will sell 5,000 rupees bond. Put it up. And buy shares for what? 5,000 to make it 45. Put it up. What I am doing is, at the time when the price is dropping, the strategy makes me buy. Put it up. When there is a fall in price, the strategy makes me what? Buy. Because at that time only we will not buy. Put it up. We will not buy when the stock market is crashing, but the strategy makers want buy, because buy when the prices are what? Low is a strategy. Any opportunity? No. But my fear is, this is the lowest price, will it further reduce? I'll be waiting or not? This will not be making me wait. It make me what? Buy immediately. Everybody follow what I'm saying? Now, in that case, I'll sell 5,000 bond and then invest in what? Share. This happened next day. Suppose this 45,000, I'm holding more shares or not? This one day become 70. How much rupees here? 70. What the bond amount? 40. Can I make the 75 easier? It become what? 75. The bond becomes how much? Bond is 45. What the portfolio value? 1,20,000. Isn't 1 is 1? No. What should be my proportion? 60,000 and then what? 60,000. What I will do is, the price of shares has what? Increase. When there's an increase in trend, book the profit and come out. Respond. Yes or no? In that case, what they say is, I have to sell share worth what? 15,000. Book the profit in the market, put in what? Save a place, call us what? Bond, and start earning interest. Yes or no? Now, that is, it does not make me wait too long to book profit, because at that time it may start falling. It does not make me wait too long to buy and what? Cheaper price, because at that time the price may start what? Increasing. So this plan, what it does is, it always makes me buy when the prices are crashing, make me what? Sell when the prices are what? Raising. I may not book bumper profit or loss, that is sure, because I may sell at this price, it may even go up to 1,20,000, nobody knows. You don't know what I'm saying, but it will not make me greedy, it may be what? Disciplined in my share market approach. Respond, you don't know. No. This plan is called as what plan? Constant ratio plan. No. In this case, what happens is, daily share price increase and decrease or not? My proportion will be changing. No. In that case, daily when I buy and sell, when a financial institution, okay, like mutual fund. But if I am a normal person, I'm going to have brokerage, lot of cost. I'm going to have a lot of brokerage or not? No. What I do is, I always keep a threshold. If it increases beyond 15%, lakh. Crashes beyond what? 10%, just what? Act. So, one or two small percent change, I don't worry about the problem, I keep quiet. When I will act, when the change is what? Substantial, I fix the threshold for me. If the change is more than 15% upside or what? Downside, then I'll buy and sell. I can have a trigger point and then do the purchasing and selling it. Enna purinjadha what I'm saying now? Like that only this question is telling you. Any other question purinjadha? Now, come back to the question. Tell me, Sunidhi is having how much money?
2 lakhs.
2 lakhs. She is investing the 2 lakhs in which place? Bond to 1 lakh and then equity fund how much? Yeah, 1 lakh. She is buying a mutual fund. What mutual fund? Equity mutual fund how much is here? 1 lakh and bond how much? 1 lakh. Respond is or no? And what she does is, every time when the NAV jumps up and down more than what? 15%, she is going to act in the way which I discussed now. Are you following what I am saying? No. The one problem is, beginning of the December she purchases on Agadaba. Correct, she purchased what? Beginning of the December. But this NAV is what? End of the December. Please tell me yes or no. No. So institute has used this as what? Beginning of December. So we can understand this 40 alone to be what? The entry date NAV at the beginning of December. Inconsistency in the question only, we can understand that. Leave the small mistake, let's see the remaining part of the solution is going to be much more better. That is, when I entered with 1 lakh in the mutual fund, they allotted me how many units? At 40 rupees, 2500 units allotted, right or not? From there onwards, I will start doing the solution. There's 40 rupees, assumed we want December, beginning NAV, that's an assumption can be made. This is the first NAV in which I am entering into the fund. Can I start or not? That's the inconsistency in the question that I accepted, but let's proceed further. It's an RTP sum. Can I start or not? Let's start with the solution, please. I cannot give you time to copy, very long to copy. Let's do it what? Together. Please. Constant ratio plan. Constant ratio plan. Constant ratio plan. Can we start up? Now. Have the following columns. Quickly copy the column. I did not give because you will not understand all the calculation in one go when I give you the printout, hence we are doing it. Okay. These chapters are very regularly asked. Even if you spend 10 minutes extra time, worth it. Understand and write it. Other important. Finish opening the columns, sir. Month, NAV, percentage change, rebalance. It is what rebalance. Bond, equity, portfolio value, units purchased or sold, and then units. If you don't have space, turn the page this way and then start writing. Anyway, whichever you feel comfortable. Can I start now? Please. If you're not able to read the slide, hear me and write. Can I say it? No, first, help. December, that's when I entered the market na December. Don't think about beginning, end and all. December, leave it, that's all. Okay, otherwise we'll be getting more confused with the question. December, when I entered, what the NAV? 40. Now only entering, no change. Kadaba? Now, no change. How much I invested in bond? 1 lakh. Bond investor 1 lakh, equity 1 lakh. That's the equity mutual fund, that's the meaning. What the portfolio value? 2 lakhs, okay, now. What is the units purchased or sold? 1 lakh by 40. How many units purchased? 2,500 units. Purchased 2,500 units. The units is now in hand, 2,500. Units now in hand is 2,500. Finished. Write in the first row or not? Okay, next. January. I just write two rows for every month, before rebalancing, after rebalancing, before rebalancing. On January, the NAV become how much? 25. Has the NAV changed or not changed? Change. From 40 drop to what? 25. Calculate how much is drop? 15. From what? 40. 15 by 14 to 100, what a percentage change? 37.5% change. Will she add or will not add? She will add. It is more than what? 15% change. Na? Rebalance, yes or no? Yes. We should do the rebalance. At present, my bond value is 1 lakh. At present, my bond value is 1 lakh. Now tell me, 2500 units in how much rupees? 25. What is the mutual fund value? What is the number? Tell me how much number? 62,500. 62,500. So it is 2,500 into 25 gives you 62,500. Can I proceed or not? No. Tell me, what is the portfolio value? 1,62,500. So units purchase will be writing in the next row. Leave it. What are the units in hand till now? 2,500. January after. The word after means what? After rebalancing. January after rebalancing. So every month two rows will be there before rebalancing, after rebalance. If at all you are going to rebalance, okay. Now, what the NAV? 25. No need to have percentage change, no need to write rebalance. Now tell me, I should have equal amount or not?
Yes.
162,500 divided by 2, constant ratio plan. What is bond amount? 81,250. What is equity mutual fund amount? 81,250. The portfolio should be how much? 162,500. I rebalance my portfolio to be having a constant proportion. To be having what? Constant proportion of 81,250. Respond, yes or no? Now, answer me. I should sell what? Buy what? Sell what? Bonds. And buy what? Equity fund. Yes or no? Now. How much bond should I sell? That is 1 lakh minus 81 to what amount here? 18,750. That should be divided by how much NAV? 25. Tell me how many units can be purchased here? 750 units. Purchase 750 units. I hope I need not tell you the calculation. Understand it or not?
Yes, sir.
No. How many units? 750 units. Should I tell? Okay, if you want in bracket, right? 18,750 divided by 25. Back and right, 18,750 divided by 25. Now, how many units with me? 3,250. Is it a good decision? Yes, because when the markets are falling, this plan makes me what? Buy the units so that I can accumulate when the price is cheap and enjoy when the price is on high and book the margin. Yes or no? Now, next is February before balancing. It shot up to how much rupees? 36. It increased to 36. Tell me how much it started from 25, went up to what? 36. How much increase? 11 rupees divided by 25. What increase? 44%. Are you all doing with me? Now, rebalance or not? Yes. What the bond value? 81,250. Now, please tell me the share value. 3,250 units in how much rupees? 36. Multiply 3250 into 30 gives how much a base?
1,17,000.
Gives you 1,17,000. What's the portfolio value? 1,98,250. Same way we do in the option writing in Greek letter called a stop loss strategy. Can I proceed? It works almost a similar way. Okay, it is 1,98,250. Divided by how much NAV? Sorry. Units not required, what amount? 3,250 off. Can I proceed? Next. February after rebalancing. NAV same 36. No need to write these. Tell me that portfolio equally rebalanced becomes 198,250 divided by 2. I want a number. 99,125. What is the equity? 99,125. What the portfolio value? 1,98,250. Portfolio value 198,250. Now, tell me I should buy what? Sell what? I should sell what? Equity. I should buy what? Bond. You know, when the amount is size, sell and book profit. Don't wait for much more higher profit. It can be lost. Yes or no? A bird in the hand is better than what? Two in the bush, same here also, right or not? Now, please tell me the difference here. What is the amount to be sold, sir? 1,17,000 minus what? 99,125. Sold, what is the amount? How many days? 17,875. Should be divided by how much rupees? 36. Tell me what is the number? I am going to redeem the units of purchase or redeem. I am going to sell 496.53 units. Tell me what is the number of units I am going to have? 2753.47 units. 2753.47 units. Everybody understanding it or not? Now, next is month of what? March. Okay. March 1, what is the NAV? 32. NAV is 32. It has decreased by 4 out of 11%. 11.11. Good month. 11.11. Balance up, no balance up. You know, I act only when there's going to be a 15% swing. She is having a threshold to react. Okay. So I don't rebalance. Bond is 99,125. bond 99,125. The equity fund will be 2753.47 into how much rupees? 32. 2743.57 into 32. How much going to be how much rupees? 88,111. 88,111. The portfolio value is 1,87,236. Portfolio value 1,87,236. 187,236. No purchase and sale. I continue to have what? 2753.47. 2753.47. Next month is what? April. What is the NAV? 38. The percentage is 18.75. Will I react or not? Yes. I go for rebalance. Yes. 99,125. The amount is 99,125. No. So what is the equity value? 2753.47 into 38. 1,04,632. 104,632. The portfolio value is 203,757. Portfolio value is 203,757. Units purchased or sold, that is, you have to do it later. The units is 2753.47. 2753.47. Now, after rebalancing, 38, no change. Bond value should be, tell me, 203,757 divided by 2. What should be the bond value? 101,878. 101,878. And equity should be 101,879. 101,879. So not to write in decimals, I round off in one side. 101,879. Portfolio value 203,757. Answer me, I am going to sell what? Buy what?
Sell
equity and buy what? Bond. How many equity should be sold here? 104,632 minus what? 101,870. What's the amount? 2753. Okay. Divided by how much here? 38. What number of units? Sell 72.46 units. 72.46 or 45. 72.46 units. Now tell me what the number of units in hand? 2681.01. Everybody understanding it or not? No. Don't shout. Leave 4 or 5 line space. Leave a 4 or 5 line space to complete the sum. Can't you continue and complete or not? Our May, June, July only are going to happen. You complete the sum on your own. Just don't copy everything. If you copy, I will not give you time. Write only the last row. Okay, September, write the last row, please. Other answer, okay, write the last row, September. Leave around 5 or 6 line space, sufficient space to write the rebalancing and all. September, write as I dictate, NAV 52. Don't write anything. Prohibit that. NAV what? 52. Copyright with me for others. Okay. NAV 52. Percentage change 4%. Percentage change 4%. No. Rebalancing is no. 117,964. Okay. And repeat. September. NAV 52. SCP 52. 4%. NO. Now, small words here. No. 117,964, 122,683, total is 2,40,647, 2,40,647, 2359.29, 2359.29. Okay, 2359.29. Can I proceed? No. Dictated last row over here. Okay, now. I'll read the last two numbers. Okay, now. 240, 647, now. 2359.29. 2359.29. Finish or not? No. Please. Now. Your portfolio has become worth how much rupees here? 2,40,647. You invested 2 lakhs. Manager increased what? 2,40,647. Using this constant ratio plan. Yes or no? No. Please. The other option is passive buy and hold. Passive what? Buy and hold. You invested 1 lakh. That's all. Don't do anything. See only after what? September, what has happened? Any opinion? No. Write down. Next. under constant ratio plan, please. Under constant ratio plan, please. Under constant ratio plan, the portfolio value on September end is, under constant ratio plan, the portfolio value on September end is, the portfolio value on September end is what? 2,40,647. September end is 2,40,647. 2,40,647. Can I proceed? Right on. Next. Part 2. Passive hold and buy strategy. Sorry, passive buy and hold strategy. Passive buy and hold strategy. You buy and hold it. You don't change and all. Okay. Passive buy and hold strategy. Passive buy and hold strategy. Can I proceed or not? Now, add on. In this strategy, we invested 1 lakh in bond. In this strategy, we invested 1 lakh in bond. We invested 1 lakh in bond and 1 lakh in equity fund. We invested 1 lakh in bond and 1 lakh in equity fund, getting how many units? 2,500 units. We invested 1 lakh in bond and 1 lakh in equity fund, getting 2,500 units in December. In December. This is point number 1. Can I proceed? Point 2. In September, the portfolio value is, in September, the portfolio value is, right, one below another. For the first item, bond. What is the bond value? 1 lakh. We assume that the bond will not change in value. It is there, a small change only will be there, up and down due to yield change. Okay, that you ignore it. Bond value, 1 lakh. Next is what? Equity. How many units? 2,500. Now has become how much rupees? 52. Tell me the amount. 1 lakh? 30,000. 1 lakh 30,000. Portfolio value is 2 lakh 30,000. Good calculation. 2 lakh 30,000. Okay. Portfolio value is 2 lakh 30,000. Portfolio value 2 lakh 30,000. Okay. This is what we can earn from passive buy and hold. Now, don't think that it can be only 2 lakh 30. You can even reach what? 60 or 70 can become much more. Okay, but what I have to say is, this value is much more volatile. Is much more what? Volatile than a constant ratio plan, because in constant ratio plan, I'll book profit immediately. I'll start buying when what? It becomes cheaper. It's going to be much more constant return compared to what? This passive buy and hold strategy. Respond, are you following or not? Now, write down notes. Constant ratio plan. Constant ratio plan. Point number 1. Investment should be dispassionate. Investment should be dispassionate. You should not be having passion. One should be looking as an outsider. It is not your money, somebody money, what you will do like that. Investment should be what? Dispassionate. Investment should be dispassionate. That is, one should not panic when prices fall. One should not panic when prices fall and be greedy when prices increase. One should not panic when prices fall and be greedy when prices increase. Now, rumba simple. If you do this, what happens here? When you panic when the price fall, what will do? Immediately sell. Now I am holding, at least I can sell for 50. What will become what? 40. Immediately what? Sell. Okay. greedy, you know, it has become 60, it may become what? 90 will be water, waiting, okay. Both are water, risking only. Yes or no? One should not panic when the price is false. Greedy when the price is what? Increase. Next point number 102 or 2. This constant ratio plan makes the investor buy. The constant ratio plan makes the investor buy when the prices are falling. Make the investor buy when the prices are falling. And sell when the prices are increasing. That is, profits are booked and transferred to bond markets. Profits are booked and transferred to bond markets during price increase. And bonds are diluted. Bonds are diluted and transferred to equity markets when the prices are falling. So you understand this plan or not? This is what we call as a constant ratio plan. Okay, now we have only few small issues. One is the mutual fund performance measure. That's the three ratios are there. That can be done in no time. And also one more area, I think it is. One problem is pending. That's all. These two issues are pending. We'll complete that. And next class, morning we'll do also the currency futures with the solution. And then start with the mutual funds. Okay.